Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Come on, somebody celebrate Jesus this morning. I don't know about you, but I'm excited to be in the house of the Lord on this morning. And so wherever you are able, I ask that you stand now for the processional of the choir. Let us welcome them as they come to sing to the glory of God.
Thank you.
remain standing and we prepare to enter into this Young Adult Sunday. We will be led this morning by our young adults, and we will begin with our call to worship. And if you lift your eyes to the screen or onto the bulletins, let us read that responsively. How long shall the wicked prosper and injustice reign in our land? How long shall the weak and needy be trampled over by the feet of those intoxicated with greed and power?
O Lord, not long. Make us an instrument of thy justice.
How long shall the voiceless be without a voice? How long, O God, shall the hungry be given the crumbs of the full?
O Lord, not long. Make us an instrument of thy justice.
How long shall we remain silent in the face of injustice and oppression? How long shall we lower our voices to protect our own security and agendas?
O Lord, not long. Make us an instrument of thy justice.
Come, ye chosen of God, and worship the Lord who calls us to battle the injustices of our land. Come, you saints created in the image of God and endowed with God's power, and do what God requires of us. We shall do justice. We shall love kindness. We shall walk humbly with you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let us turn into our hymnals to 508. This morning's hymn is Swing Low, Sweet Chariots. Of the Lord. And as we still our hearts and prepare to receive that which God has for us this morning. Let us quiet ourselves and remove the distractions that would prevent us from hearing from him. This morning, our invocation will be led by Ms. Ashley Patterson. Oh, Lord, we come to you this morning, Lord, with a heart of praise, Lord. With a heart of praise, Lord, for all you've done for us. In just this one week, Lord, there's nothing we can do to repay you, Lord. We come to you with humble hearts, with hearts desiring more of you, Lord. Some of us may have come with heavy hearts, Lord, with things that have gone on this week, Lord, this year, Lord. But I ask you to please allow us to submit ourselves unto you, Lord. Set them aside for just a moment, Lord, so that we can feel and see your glory, so that we can see your power work today, Lord, because we know that there is no problem, no trouble that you cannot conquer, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We are trusting in you, Lord, for what you will do, Lord. Come into our presence, Lord. Fill our hearts with your love, Lord, so that we can walk out of here in a different way than which we came, Lord. Oh, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for yet another day to spend in your presence, Lord. I ask you to please bless us. Keep your hand upon us, Lord. Help us to follow you and hear your word, Lord, when you speak, Lord. Oh, I thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Of you.
such a mighty God. Such a mighty God. Because of who you are, Jesus. We worship you. We worship you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. This morning, but the Spirit of God is moving in this place today to break strongholds and to break chains and to break bondage. So whatever you came in seeking today, know that the God that we serve is a living God, and the God that we serve is able to provide for your every need, and the God that we serve loves you unconditionally. It doesn't matter what you've been through or what you've done. Just know that the Lord loves you and cares for you and wants to be your Savior. Hallelujah this morning. Hallelujah this morning. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's so good. We serve a mighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes you just have to cry out because you know how good God has been to you. Sometimes you got to stand up and shout and sing and dance and run and praise him and fall out prostrate before him, because you don't know what God has done in somebody else's life. You don't know how God has touched someone else's life. And so we ought to worship him with everything that we have in our being, because the Lord truly has been good to us. Amen. As we continue in worship this morning, we have a special ministry opportunity from our dancers. Let them come now. Let us welcome our sisters in praise as they prepare to continue in this spirit of worship.
Oh, you might save some. So in Japan, you got to say, Tamina wa yo wakari wa shita uchika no yomi. Shiyo wa gana tana shiya koko yoshi. When you go to places like Holland, in the country of Holland, there are cities like Amsterdam, The Hague, Rotterdam, and they all speak Dutch there, so you can't just go there and say, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. Nobody said anything about that because you've never heard of that place. You're like, Sur who? Suriname. And there they speak a language called Surinamese. I'm still getting a zero here. No, it's not registering. And when you go down to Suriname, you know, there's a song that I sing, and it just simply goes, and they scream like we've just said something great, and y'all sitting there saying, what? We're gonna try it again. God of them, I'm going to know. God of them, I'm going to know. One, two, three.
Bulletins to page 7 and following, we want to remind everyone that it's time to V-O-T-E. Vote! At the bottom of page 8, you see that early voting has begun in our area, and we hope that if you are not registered, that you will stop by the table in the narthex. We want to help. There's no shame in not being registered. The shame is in not going ahead and seeing that it gets done. And so we want you to stop by the table, whether you're registered or not. Just put your hand on it if you're registered. Say a prayer for those who are not. We need to see a change come in our time, in our time. Amen. 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 We want to also remind everyone that this is the second month of our Walking with God series in Bible study. Reverend Connie Dickerson will be leading us this month, and the scriptures are printed there for those of you who do not have the book. We hope that you will be prayerful and attend on Wednesday evening. We're having a wonderful time in the Lord through the Journey with God series, and so we hope that you will come on Wednesday evening, that you will be on the prayer call on Wednesday morning. We want to remind you also that LEM, L-E-M, Life Enhancement Ministry, is sponsoring the Senior DuPage Luncheon on Thursday of this week from 11 to 1:30 for all our 70-plus members. And you are invited to come out for that activity. Amen. Amen. We're gearing up for the DuPage Theater Group presentation that is coming up this fall as well. Amen. All of this is listed in your bulletin. We hope you'll take your bulletins with you. We want to ask if Sister Denise is prepared to come again at this time, that we might hear from our delegate to the 136th session of the Chicago Annual Conference. Amen.
We had a wonderful, wonderful time. Last week, I used to say that I attend an AME church, and now I can say, after attending that conference, I am AME. I have learned a lot. My husband joined me. We both learned quite a bit about the ins and outs of the AME, and we have so much more to learn, and we will continue to be diligent in that regard. There was some business taken care of at the conference, and that business was, our pastor, Bishop, Bishop White, put our pastor, James F. Miller, back in place here at DuPage AME. We are so, so thankful, and this will be his 30th assignment here with us, and I would ask that our steward come and say something, Daryl Parks, to Pastor Miller and Reverend Lana.
Thank you. To Pastor Miller, Reverend Lana, I'm proud, as a representative of Mr. Leo Raspberry, who was our vice chair of our steward board, to present to you this pastor's certificate of pastor's appointment. The Reverend James F. Miller is appointed pastor of DuPage AME Church. That said charge being under the jurisdiction of the Chicago Annual Conference of the African Methodist Episcopal Church, given under my hand and denominational seal at this Episcopal room on the 29th day of September 2018, signed on behalf of the Annual Conference, Bishop John F. White. Reverend Lana, Pastor Miller, congratulations, and we wouldn't have it any other way. God bless you both.
Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Somebody who loves the Lord, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And if he's been good to you lately, give him a praise offering. A praise offering. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'd like to say in the AME church where we are assigned 1 year at a time, that I have not now been back for 30 years, but I've been back 30 times. Just think about relationship. Think about relationship. If you think in terms of years or dates, what would you think of a person that you dated once or twice or six times as opposed to a person you dated 30 times? You waiting on that person to go a little bit farther, ain't you? Because we're getting regular, aren't you? Let's go a little further, church, because we're getting regular, all right? Come on, let's praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to thank the steward board. I want to thank our delegate, Sister Denise Parks. I want to thank our alternate delegate, Angela Pettis. I want to thank O.C. Davenport and Denise Taylor. They were there almost all the week. And all of the persons that helped us. And I just thank God to come back. If I was a new pastor coming for my first time, I wouldn't know how to pastor this church. There's so much going on. Pastor Bailey is here, retired, and he didn't have to worry about getting an appointment. All he had to do is stay home and hear about what they did while he watched the football game. I'll be there soon, Reverend. But I would come and see this great dance ministry that we have and this choir that's singing this morning as the men did earlier, and I would just thank the Lord. I'd pull around the corner. I grew up on the south side of Chicago. Every day, I drive down these tree-lined streets. Every day, I look at these manicured lawns. Got four or five shopping centers. I had to decide where I'm gonna shop. Go to restaurants, so many restaurants around here, we getting the biggest fight we have, where we gonna eat today. Well, let's wore out all these fine restaurants. Just accommodation, access, entree in this community. So beside the miracle, I'm just thankful that the Lord has been good. Anybody here come from somewhere? Did he bring anybody from here to there? I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And praise the Lord.
Amen. 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 We're both glad about it. Amen. Glad to be back with all of you. Amen. Amen. Looking forward to see what the Lord is going to do with all of us. Amen. Amen. We want to take a moment just to see if we have any visitors with us today. If you're visiting today, we'd like to invite you to stand. Do we have any visitors? Amen. 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 Please introduce yourself to us. Tell us your name, who you're with, how you came to be with us today. Amen, amen, amen. We're glad to have you. On behalf of the pastor and everyone in the DuPage Amory Church family, we're blessed to have you. Amen, amen. It's good to see Sandra, too. Amen. I don't want to miss anybody, but I'm turning. Okay. Tell us your name and who you're with, how you came to be here. Amen, amen, amen. Welcome, welcome, welcome. God bless you. We are going to stand now while you keep your seats. We just want to serenade you to the glory of God. Yes, we do.
This morning, I don't know about you, but my spirit is filled and I'm excited about what we're going into going to see in a moment. As we continue in worship and prepare to give our tithes and offerings, I ask that our two officers come, Ms. Raina Scott and Bryant Beal, and as our scouts are preparing to come in to receive our offerings, let us lift up our eyes to the screen or in our bulletins. Read that green box, readjusting our starting point together. We don't get our lives together and then give them to God, but rather we give our lives to God and then things start coming together. As our hearts open, our talents and gifts begin to blossom. Many believe that once they're successful and have made a lot of money, they will use that success to help the world, but that's a delay technique by which ego tries to keep us from showing up fully in our own lives. Even if we don't yet consider ourselves successful, we can devote our work now to being used in the service of the healing of the world. From that point of power, our careers will take off. Our steps are made firm by the Lord when God delights in our way. Psalm 37, 23. Are you a tither? Will you become one today? Let us pray.
Dear Lord, thank you for today. Thank you for bringing us through another week. Thank you for all the blessings that you've given us this week, and that we have a chance to just give back a small portion of that which you've given to us. I pray that you bless these tithes and offerings, bless those who are giving and those who maybe aren't able to give.
Yes.
And I pray that these tithes can go into furthering your kingdom. Pray this in your name. Amen.
Amen. First plate is for tithes and offerings. Second plate for mission and outreach. You may place your offering in the offering plate. You may text to give your offering. The instructions are printed just above the green box in the bulletin or on the screen. There's also an electronic kiosk in the narthex that you can go and give your offering. And if you just need one more way, you can go to our website, www.dupageamec.org, and give your offering there. after the ushers have left the sanctuary, there will be an Angel Church worship experience for our littlest ones in Angel Church. That is those little people ages 2 to 6. But the rest of us will remain in the sanctuary and worship together. Amen. And boy, do we have a treat for you today. I am so excited because our pastor is such a loving and giving servant leader, and he's given the young adults the opportunity to change service up a little bit. So who's in need of a revival this morning? Who came here knowing that they needed something of the Lord? Just a touch, just a word, just a song, just a smile, just a hug, just to be in the presence of the living God and a congregation who will rest themselves around us and love us. Hallelujah. I'm telling you today that what you came in here seeking, that which you will find on today. We have a dynamic, we've been having a dynamic service, and we will continue to worship. And as I said, we have a treat for you this morning. Yes, still morning. We have 3 dynamic preachers for you today. Praise God for them. Those who've been called to preach and to touch our hearts. So after the choir brings us one more wonderful selection, we will hear from Brother Malcolm Franklin, Sister Alexis Wilson, and Reverend Morgan Dixon. Praise God for them as they come.
Praise the Lord, church. Thank God for another day and for another opportunity to serve. We just thank God for being so good. We thank you, Lord, for your presence here with us today. Thanking Pastor Miller and Reverend Lana, and thanking God for them being appointed for a 30th time. We just thank you, Lord, for today. We thank you, God, for each new day, and each new set of mercies that you bring to us. We just pray, Lord God, that you will use me and use these preachers this morning, Lord God, to send your word forth in the name of Jesus. Let the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts, Lord God, be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, our strength and most certainly our Redeemer. I'd like to lift up a word of scripture coming from the book of Genesis, the second chapter, verse 7.